I've made a copy of ODB 67, and I'm calling this one ODB 68 Reports from Design View. To see how Design View works, we're going to create those same two reports we created in the last two videos, only this time from Design View. Going into Reports and clicking on Create Report in Design View, we see that the Add Field dialog box is opened, as well as our Properties dialog box, and this is pointing to the Data tab. We've got a content type of table, and the contents is pointing to the first table it finds alphabetically, and the fields from this table are displayed in the Add Field dialog box. We're going to change this from Table to Query, and we notice that it blanks out our contents and our Add Field fields. I will select our ODB66 employee info. I'm going to select all the fields, clicking on the first one, holding down Shift, and clicking the last one. Then I'm going to click on the Insert, and we can close our Add Field dialog box. And if that accidentally gets closed, we can always open it up again with Add Fields, or from the view, Add Field. We want this to be similar to the previous report, so I'm going to select all of the detail and make that a little bit longer. Now I'm going to hide the properties box so I can select all the fields and center them a little better. I will add our header. I want this to say list of employees, and we're going to change that font as well as an underline, just like we had in the other report. Dot dot dash bold, I think it was, and then the font was Georgia bold 22. And we need to add our page numbers. Page N of M at the bottom, we want that to be centered. Let's shrink down our footer and our headers, shrink from both sides. We also want to go into Format, Page, and change our top and bottom margins to 0.5. I will save this. ODB68 Columnar Design View, save, and we'll run it. Looks like we need a little space between the employees. So I will just add a little bit here on the bottom. And I also want to mention, if I click down here in this gray area, it brings back our report properties, going back into the Data tab. If I change the report output format from ODF text document, we can change this to spreadsheet. Let's rerun this. We see it brings up our report in a spreadsheet. So we can do a little bit of manipulation if we need to, spread those out. This is in a calc view, so we can print out the report from there. But we will notice that the page numbering does not work down here. It just has page of at the bottom. So I'm going to change this back into text and rerun it. And that looks pretty good for our columnar report. Now let's create the tabular report. Save. And I'm going to save the database. I'm going to create a report in Design View again. Let's change the content type to query, ODB66 employee info, and bring all that information into our report. Now we've got a problem. We've got our page header, our page footer, and our detail, but we don't have that blue header that we had before, that group header. To get that, I'm going to click in this page header area, right click, and bring up that sorting and grouping. If I click in the field expression, it brings up a drop down. I need to click that and then click again in this blank area, and this way it will assign the entire query as the group. I want to put all my labels into the header, so I'm going to select them and move them up into the header area. Maybe move them down a little bit and make a little space down here so I can move down our detail fields. First thing we want is the employee ID and the employee ID detail. I want them to go to the far left, so I'm going to click the left align on section. The employee ID fields are a little bit big, so I'm going to change the width to be 0.8. And then I'm also going to bring these right to the top. Selecting just the label instead of employee ID, I'm going to change that to EMP-ID. And I want to center both of these. Now let's go to the last name, and coming down to last name, I'm going to hold down shift and click last name here, and then the arrow to bring those both to the top and force them left. Now let's do the first name, clicking that, clicking the first, holding down shift, clicking first name. Now I can't bring this straight up because we've got the last name here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send this to the far right. Then I'm going to go up and then to the far left, and it lines them up. Now I want department, hold down shift, department, send to the far right, then up, then far left. Let's just close this properties box for the moment. We're running out of space on the page. To correct this, I'm going to go into format, page, and change the orientation to landscape. While I'm here, I'm also going to change the top and bottom margins to 0.5 and 0.5. Now I can do the group name, select, hold down shift, group name, go to the far right, going up to the far left, and the same thing with hourly wage. I'm going to select these and move them over to the right a little bit, so that we can see this all the way through. We go into the far right, then we're going up, and then to the far left. Let's make this a little smaller. Make our detail area a little smaller. We want to put in the header and the page numbering. I'll insert the page numbering. Page numbers, N of M, bottom of page, center, and then we want to add in our label. We want this label to be list of employees, and we're going to change the font. We want the underline dot dot dash bold, then the font to be Georgia bold 22. Let's bring down the page numbering just a little. I'm going to click on the headers and shrink from both sides. Then click on the page footer and shrink from the bottom. And let's save this as ODB68 tabular design view. Now let's run this. we see that our labels are not bold and they're not flowing over to the next page. To correct this, I'm going to select all of our labels in the header, holding down Shift and clicking on each one of these. Then I'm going to come up and click on Bold. To get this to show up on the next pages, we need to open up the properties and be in the header. Here's where we need to update repeat section from no to yes. Let's save this and run it. Now we've got our labels, our header, our data, page 1 of 3. We've got the labels on the next page, 2 of 3 and 3 of 3.